If you spent any amount of time at all in Google Analytics, you've probably come across something called bounce rate. Well, really, that's just a measure of engagement. In fact, there's a whole section of reports that are all about engagement that show you exactly how engaging your site is for your users. But you gotta learn how to read them. And in this video, we're gonna cover exactly that. Now we're going to take a step back before we jump into analytics to talk about why we're using Google Analytics in the first place. Think about it in terms of a conversation. Users are coming to your site and your website is having a conversation with those users to hopefully get them to become a customer. If you think about it, that's what happens if they come to an offline store. If they'd have to interact with a salesperson, that salesperson would help them purchase their products. Well, your website's basically doing the same thing, and Google Analytics is how we can listen for that conversation. We can actually understand how the users are interacting with the website. Another way to think about the conversation is the word engagement. In Google Analytics, we can look at a report and we can see the engagement level of users. We can understand if they're not engaging at all, it means they're having a bad conversation. We might want to change some of the marketing messages. Or are they engaging a lot, in which case we'd expect that they would ultimately become purchasers. Now let's take a look at where this is in Google Analytics. But we're going to jump into what is my favorite report, which is the Source Medium report. From the home screen, you're going to go into Acquisition, and then we're gonna go into all traffic, source medium. And at that point, we have our report that tells us where our traffic is coming from. We know the amount of traffic we're getting from these different traffic sources. We have our engagement metrics, which we're gonna come back to in just a moment. And ultimately, we have the results of all of that engagement. Now, if yours doesn't quite look like mine, and you see we have email here and partner traffic and CPC, those are something called UTMs. And that's something that you do want to make sure you have as a skill. You gotta make sure that you are properly using UTMs to tag your traffic. Be sure to check the description below because you're going to see links to videos we've done to help you do exactly that. Now, in this Source Medium report, what we're going to focus on is this middle section right in here under behavior. Now, you see there are three main metrics. First is the bounce rate, then there's pages per session, and then average session duration. They're just measures of engagement. Bounce rate is essentially Google Analytics telling you everybody that came to your site and left without seeing another page. Pages per session is Google Analytics telling you, okay, these are how many pages they saw in the visit that they had with your site. And then average session duration is, this is how long they stuck around. So what we have here is the overall site-wide number of bounce rate, pages per session, and of course, average session duration. And then underneath it, you see that it's broken down in this case by traffic source. So it's good to know that my bounce rate is 27% site-wide, but I can't really do anything with that. In order to actually do something with this information, we have to drill down, in this case, by traffic source. So I can see here, we've got a bounce rate that says 31, and I see another bounce rate that says 12. So people coming directly to my site have a bounce rate of about the same as my site-wide bounce rate. But if you look at the Infusionsoft email traffic, it's about half that. The people coming from email are twice as engaged as the people who are coming directly to the site. But what about the other traffic sources? I can see my search traffic also about the same as the overall site traffic, not as engaged as what email traffic is. Is that what I would expect? Sure. They've probably just recently heard about us, so they're maybe not as likely to engage. But email traffic, they have totally heard about us. They already know, like, and trust our brand. They're coming back again and again and again. So we would expect the bounce rate to be lower, and we would expect to have a better conversation with that particular traffic source. And so far, it looks like we are. Now, if I go to this other email, you'll notice the bounce rate goes way up. So what's the difference? They're both email. Wouldn't you expect the bounce rate to be the same? Well, the difference is this email is our own internal list. So we're mailing that list. It's our customers, it's our leads, our toolbox members. Everybody understands the brand and they're coming back over and over, so they're a lot more engaged. This particular email was people that didn't know about us yet. They were learning about us at the very early stages of working with our company. So we would expect a higher bounce rate, not as engaged. Let's move on to pages per session. Here, I can see my email is at 5 pages per session, but my site-wide, I'm almost at 4, which means email, they're actually seeing a lot more pages when they're staying on their visits with us. Now, if you'll come down to this other email source, there's a higher bounce rate to begin with, so we already knew they were not as engaged, but now we're starting to get more details, and we can see, wow, instead of seeing 5 pages during their visit on average, they're only seeing barely 2. They are clearly coming in and going. Whatever the targeting is that we set up in this particular email might need to be adjusted. Whereas these other traffic sources, like organic, for example, even though the bounce rate's higher than email, look at the number of pages. They're exploring 4 pages. That says to me, my organic is okay. I'm doing all right so far. People are searching for problems. They find us as a possible solution. And when they come to our site, yeah, some of them bounce, sure, and that's okay. But they're sticking around and they're checking out a number of our pages, which means they're going through the different offers and they're exploring our site. So what's the conversation quality we're having with them? It's a lot better conversation because we're engaging them more. This is a good sign for me. As we carry it through to average session duration, you'll see that on average, basically people spend about 19 minutes with our site, and you can see this carry through into the different traffic sources. I can see my Infusionsoft email traffic. We know it's highly engaged because the bounce rate is so low. We know that pages per session is great. They're seeing a lot of pages and they're spending some time. And look at that, they're even a lot higher when it comes to session duration. We're having a good conversation with our email list. If we look at Google Organic, I can see that they're about as engaged as an average person on our site, with the bounce rate being about the same. I can see that they're actually seeing a little more than the average in terms of pages, which is good. And they're spending at least 19 minutes with us on average. They're actually taking the time to go through the different pages. Let's look at the problem child that we have over here, which is this e-commerce unmasked emails. They're bouncing very quickly. They're not sticking around very long in terms of the number of pages that they're seeing, a little over a minute. That's it. So they are clearly coming to a page or two, checking stuff out very quickly, making a decision to go fast. So we now know the conversation that we are having with this particular email audience is very different than this particular email audience. Now, what do I do as a marketer with that? I come back in and I find out, what was this messaging that we gave them? And was it matching the expectation? When you see numbers like this, this says people came to the site, didn't find what they were looking for, and left. And they left quickly and they didn't take time to poke around. And that's a good story for me to know. It's not a story I like. It's not a conversation that I want to see. But as a marketer, I got to look at what's there, because that's what I can adjust and change. And so I would go back to that traffic source, figure out, okay, what is the information we're actually sending them? What pages are we sending them to? Does that meet their expectation? And if not, how do we improve it? So that ultimately I can see a much better story back here. Knowing what we know about how to read these reports now, let's look at another example when it comes to traffic sources. So we're gonna pick these two. We've got Facebook CPC, which is our paid traffic coming in from Facebook. And we've got traffic that's coming in from Social Media Examiner and a podcast that we recently did with them. On average, the Facebook CPC is pretty engaged. It's actually a lower bounce rate than our overall site. And when compared to the podcast traffic, it's actually quite a bit better. Now, Social Media Examiner, of course, about a little higher than what the site-wide traffic is. So they tend to bounce a little more. They're not as engaged. Our site-wide average is almost 4 pages per session. Here, we're barely over 1. While they are definitely not bouncing, which is great, they're also not looking a lot around the site. Social Media Examiner podcast, when we compare it, you can see, well, yeah, they bounce a little more, but they are exploring a little more as well. Because I know these things, I can go back to Facebook and adjust the messaging. I might go back to the pages that the podcast traffic is coming back to and adjust that messaging, because I can hear the conversation that's happening here. Now, finally, it's tied in with session duration. You can see in this case, Facebook traffic is actually spending more time than I would think. They're spending 5 minutes, whereas here, Social Media Examiner is also spending 5 minutes. So what's the story? We'll put it all together. The story for me would be Facebook paid traffic is being sent to a page which they like. That's the only page they like. They don't continue the journey and they leave. They stick around a little while to explore that one particular step, but they don't go much further. They're kind of done at that point. Whereas the Social Media Examiner podcast audience, well, they are not as likely to engage with the page that they're coming to. So they bounce a little more than average. But the ones who do engage that page engage with other pages as well. So they like what they find and they continue the journey a little bit more than Facebook does. And of course, they stick around for about the same amount of time. So I have a very different conversation happening with two different audiences. And again, I can go back now to Facebook CPC, maybe adjust my ad targeting or the landing pages that I'm sending them to, and improve that conversation so that ultimately I can improve results. All thanks to the report that we find here in Google Analytics. Now, up until this point, we've been using the Source Medium report to actually go through and understand the story of engagement that this report is trying to tell us. And because we know how to do this, we can actually leverage our new powers in other reports as well, so we can unlock those too. First, we're gonna go into one called the landing page report. We're gonna find that by going into the behavior reports. Then we go into site content, and then finally, landing pages. You're gonna notice it looks kind of familiar, because it is. It's actually the exact same type of report. Only instead of learning about traffic sources, you're learning about landing pages. You can see our site-wide averages are the same. Bounce rate, pages per session, average session duration. But the numbers down here are dramatically different, because now instead of doing it by traffic source, it's broken down by landing page. How do we read this report? I'm just gonna go quickly through two examples. One is our main homepage. The other is our members login page. People that come into measurementmarketing.io are more likely to bounce. They are also not as likely to see as many pages, and they don't stick around as long as the average site, which makes sense. Like, that to me seems okay, because the homepage is kind of a directory page. It's helping people find more about the product or services that we provide, or for them to leave because they couldn't find what they were trying to find. So those numbers were okay. Now, the member page is distinctly set up for our existing members to log in. Notice the bounce rate's really tiny, because who would come to a members page without actually logging in? So you have a very low bounce rate. Notice the pages per session, substantially higher, because members are interacting with the membership content. This average session duration here from our members is almost 3 times as long as it is for the people that are just coming into our homepage. So I can see 2 very distinctly different conversations that I'm having based on the pages that they see first in their session. Now I'm going to show you one other report where you can use these exact same skills, and that's under the audience reports. We're going to go into where it says mobile, and then right underneath that, you're going to click where it says overview. Now, this report I love because it's short, not a lot of information back there, but you can see the exact same pattern is here. So we can talk about engagement, the conversation that we're having with users. In this case, bounce rate, pages per session, average session duration, site-wide, all the same numbers, only this time it's broken down by different device categories. So in this case, I have desktop, I've got mobile, and I've got tablet. Let's look really at just desktop versus mobile. What's the story? What's the conversation that we're having with our users? Well, we can see the bounce rate on desktop is about the average of the site. But really, what I look at is how I compare it to mobile. Mobile's almost double the bounce rate as desktop. So I know that mobile users are more likely to leave faster than our desktop users right away. I can see pages per session with desktop is 4, but mobile, a little bit over 2. So almost half as many pages mobile people are seeing. They're not seeing a lot of pages. And then I can look at the time, and that story continues to just show me that mobile users are having a difficult time. Because I can see on my desktop, the session duration is 21 minutes. It's a lot of time that desktop users are spending on our site. So mobile users are more likely to leave. They don't investigate as many pages, and they don't stick around as long. What I might want to eventually do is start looking at members versus non-members, and then further segmenting this information down. It's one of the many things that Google Analytics will allow you to do. But all I'm going to do is really use the same skills that you and I just developed, figuring out what the engagement is, figuring out what the story is, figuring out what is the conversation that I'm having with my users. And now you can do that as well. Now, of course, what you just saw is a very small sliver of the conversation that you can measure for. Click here to get more tools and resources so that you can get even more insight into the bigger conversation that's already happening, or click here for 5 reports from Google Analytics that'll help you grow your business. Either way, I'll see you on the next video.